Good afternoon, everyone. Very welcome to today's session by National COE. We have Ms. Jansi. We'll be doing a session on cybersecurity with her. She is the first woman entrepreneur from Kerala to build a cyber defense center in cybersecurity. So with a strong research team, cybersecurity and geospatial technologies of Strava Technology, they are providing crucial support to startups, government, and smart cities. And also, they have been awarded as the Emerging Company Award in the year 2015. And Jansi herself received an award on Femina World Women Leadership Award in IT sector back in 2017. So thank you so much, Jansi, for joining us today. It's a pleasure to have you with us on the Cyber Talk on the Women Entrepreneur. So, We start the session, you know, it's a very peppy title. People were asking me, you know, we are doing Cyber Talk with Jansi. So we want to know about your journey, you know, how you started off as a first female cybersecurity entrepreneur in Kerala, and what is your journey so far?
Well, thank you for the great intro, Sara. So when I started my journey in the entrepreneurship, I resigned my job and started. So it's very difficult at that time to resign my job and starting an entrepreneurship life like that. And when I started my first company, it is about the geospatial technology, that is the space technology. And at that time, it is a not that much popular vertical in the space technology. So it was very difficult to understand or making understand people in what exactly the space technology and what we are actually doing. So we have a product in that space technology called CyberMonkey, which is actually for the location intelligence and all. So basically, we are developing the maps. That is what we are actually doing. And as you said, we already have a client circle of government, state, and also national government like that. It is how we just started on 2015. And in middle of that, when we take some of the project, we identify that there is a need for the cybersecurity in that time, so that we just build our cybersecurity department only for our geospatial clients to support our clients. This is how we just started on 2015. But later, due to the demand of the cybersecurity again received from some more clients, we planned to launch the cybersecurity division in a little more scale up way, and that is how the defense center just started. So we just started in Trivandrum because we are based out of Kerala, and we just developed it as a scaling of the cybersecurity of Strava Technologies, and we named it as Strava Cyber Lab, the first cyber defense center in Kerala. And we also have some other supporting offices across India in our client locations. And so this is what our journey. When we are saying what exactly the entrepreneurship from the Strava Technologies to the Strava Cyber Lab.
Great. I mean, but there would have been a lot of challenges and, you know, some achievements on the way as well while setting up Strava Technologies. So if you can tell us a little more about the organization from that point.
Yes. So when we tell about the challenges, gender specific, it is not that much challenge because in every field there are challenges. But when I already mentioned the space technology is what I am started. So when we are telling something about the map or something like that, the people just started asking about, oh, you are going to launch a satellite and you are taking the images. I said, no, it is not like that. So when compared to space technology sector and to the cybersecurity sector, it is much easier for me to make understand people what exactly we are doing in the cybersecurity, because at least they can know, they are know about that word hacking. So when we started telling about the cyber defense center, okay, I know hacking. So like that, it is much easier when compared to the space technology, but there are little bit difficulty and challenges for getting the this customers also in the cybersecurity sector. And when people understand there are some lag or there are some gap in their organization or their business, what they are doing. Mm-hmm. And we just tell them, okay, this is the need for filling that gap, and they accept that one in case of cybersecurity. That is, there is a lot of change in other sector and cybersecurity, and people are when asking or telling about the cybersecurity need in their business, they are accepting that because they know there are some gap or there are some vulnerability in their organization itself. So it is like a doctor is giving medicines and asking, telling this people, patients, like, go and have this medicine, otherwise you will die. So like that it is in the cybersecurity also. Make sure you are protected, otherwise your business will be down. So that is the way of approaches that the people or the clients already are having in their mind. So there is not that much challenge in the cybersecurity portion when dealing with the clients when compared to my other sector of space technology.
Sure. So like what I've seen is there are almost 190 plus cybersecurity companies all over the country. So how do you see Cyber Defense Center as different from other organizations, maybe in terms of, you know, the customer types you're serving, or what differentiates this center from the others?
So basically, before starting answering like what exactly our Cyber Defense Center is doing or what exactly difference in our cyber sector, Cyber Defense Center and the other companies or the organization who are right now providing the cybersecurity, let's go through the cyber attack or the global trend of the cyber attack for the last few years and the right now, this is 2020 trends. So when we focused into the cyber attacks, which we gone through the researchers, we identify that most of the cyber crimes are actually organized one right now. And as per the researchers, most of the cloud security having some of the risk. And we can actually visibly seeing that there are some targeted ransomware attack to some of the organization and even mobile malware. And lastly, when we are talking about 5G and the IoT attacks, so there are major attacks are happening based on some of the focuses some of the organization on some particular sectors only. Let's take the mobile malware attack. So we all are using the mobile. Somebody having two or somebody having more than two like that for their personal use or their official users like that. But we need to understand that the mobile is the one which we are right now using for every purposes, for checking the emails, for shopping, for watching movies or taking photos, everything. And even some of the people are saving their passwords also in the notepad of the application inside the phone itself. So when we checking this type of mobile usage and the mobile security, only a tiny fraction of people are using the mobile security in their mobile. That is the fact. So we do see a lot of cyber attack coming from the mobile phone for all type. In many cases, that is new attacks are actually called, that is multi-vector attack. Such kind of attacks are don't see in the mobile devices, but we know that all happening through the mobile devices. How I can actually explain? So when an attacker or a hacker actually getting some of the credentials from the mobile through a spyware or some of the malware, which is actually put onto the mobile. And when they leak the credential, they are actually penetrating to something in their public domain, say, for example, their Wi-Fi or even to the internal network of the offices or the organization. So there are some vulnerabilities happening, and what we are thinking is it is due to the network vulnerability in our office or something like that, but it is not like that. It is actually happened from the mobile. And the only thing we need to do is we need to secure the mobile phone by using some of the right protecting measurement or stuffs. So let's go, this is the single person perspective. Let's consider an organization perspective. So when it comes to the organization perspective, we can know that there is a model change in the generation of the security itself. So we just started on 90s or 80s, it started with the antivirus security protection. And now when we looking into the latest type of protection, we can see there is a change in the network protection, come up with the third generation, fourth generation of security. And now we are actually using the fifth generation of products and cybersecurity products, and where we already having some of the fifth generation attacks, also there is multi-vector attacks. And when we look into next level, that is when we look into 2021-22, we can absolutely know that there will be a connection of everything, that is the internet connection, that is internet of things, that is IoT, cloud, critical infrastructure. That is, everything is connected. Not only our phone to our home network, not only our devices, that is wearable devices, that is all are connected. So the hackers are actually now focusing into the sixth generation of the attack. So this is what now it is happening. But the challenges for the industry is, even if it is small or even if it is large scale, some of the organizations are actually using even the third generation of security products or for the protection and all, and the attackers are now in the sixth generation of attack. So that is the challenges which we face and our team also face when we are talking with the people or the industries, because even in the security analyst or the CISO heads, they are also facing a lot of trouble by managing the products of the organization. Product in the sense, multiple point products. They already have some of the endpoint, firewall, WAF, every product they already have. But in order to manage all those things, they are actually struggling. And even the critical asset of their organization also, they are struggling to manage the product. So there comes this Prava Cyber Labs, a cyber defense center. So we are actually supporting our organization, their organization, when it is a small or a medium. Large scale, we are not at started much more. We are right now focusing mostly in the small scale and the medium scale because there is a gap in that area. So we as a Strauss Defense Center implement, support them to implement the fifth generation policy principles like the frameworks and all. And we also help them to consolidate all the security products in one environment and in one management. And that will work because when we consolidated it in a one environment, it is easy for them to manage. Even if it is a CISO head, even some of the companies don't have CISO head, that will be easy for them to manage if it is in a consolidated framework. And most of the people are invested in SOC. But what we actually invested is in the TOC, that is Threat Operations Center. So where the Strava Cyber Lab is actually supporting the small and medium industries and some of the large scale industries in perspective of the cyber counter intelligence, say cyber threat intelligence, to protect their business assets and brand value. And we are also supporting them in perspective forensic investigation in the day-to-day dealings with the organization. And they are actually getting reports, or they are actually we are providing some of the reports also to identify the breaches in the starting stage itself. So it is easy for a security analyst or a CISO head in that particular organization to identify what is the volume of breaches or the what is the volume of gap, security gap or breaches in their organization. So that way we are supporting them by giving a forensic investigation. And we are also identifying the security gap in an auditing way. And we generate some of the policies for them. And we are grooming the employees of the organization on what to do or what not to do. That is a particular way of cyber awareness. So this is what we are actually doing sure. as a cyber defense center.
So while you were talking about this, one question that came up from one of the attendees is, maybe one or two lines how we can differentiate between a cyber defense center and a security operations center.
Okay, let's talk about again the cyber defense center, that is the TOC concept, the threat operations centers concept. Most of the companies are already having some of the security solution in their hands, but the only problem there is they need to recruit some of the expertise in each domain to look into that particular thing, or even they need to provide this as an outsourced project to somebody else who already have a SOC and to manage the entire assets of that particular organization. Since I said already we are looking into the small and medium scale organization, it is very difficult for them to give the entire project SOC to do budgetary consent and all. So now what we are providing is we are giving the top concept directly to the organization where they can actually manage, and we can actually manage from their client surface itself. They don't want to give any data to outside. That is on-premise solution we are actually providing. So when we detailing or describing it in a one word, if an organization is looking for a security solution that you can layer on top of the existing security solution, then this is the word, that is cyber defense center is the word. or if you don't want to spend more on recruiting each expertise to manage the internal asset, or if you have the doubt that somebody is leaking your confidential business data, which is very confidential or sensitive data from their organization, then the DOC is the services we can actually provide it to them as a cyber defense center. So this is what I can explain.
Great. And Jansi, as you know, a lot of students have also joined us today from different institutions. So I'm sure these students want to know that how do you identify the talent pool in cybersecurity? And what do you think is the gap between the existing talent pool from the students' perspective?
Okay. First of all, it is a very challenging part in every organization, not really our organization, but in every organization, that is the challenging part to deal with the freshers or the newcomers or the employees. So when we are developing as a cyber defense center, it is little more challenging for us to get people into onboarding. And they are going to dealing with the customer sensitive data. So customer is also having some of the doubt how we are actually handling the customer sensitive data and where the hackers are also looking into. So that is the space we are also handling very vigilantly. And we have a separate team who already have a trained background for this type of recruiting. And they just groom our people, and which include, once the application will receive, we have certain internal agendas for taking this one. And it is just went through some of the psychometric analysis, knowledge, topic knowledge sharing, criminal background checking, social media behavior analysis, etc. is what our team is actually doing. And even when they are recruited, we assign only less involvement to real clients for a period of 6 to 8 months. That is in the, as we are actually telling, it's a cooling period. And this time we will groom them and analyze their activities and attitude on how they explore and react on that particular new thing. So there will be some challenges also. So based on these activities and attitude, which getting from the report from this, the trainers, we will make them in different group. So we just allotted in some different group and in a hierarchical way we are actually placing. And the one of the major agenda is all this group are actually separated with their own internal agenda. And that is how we just avoiding the internal threats to protect our customers' data, that is the sensitive data. When coming back to the student perspective, as per my knowledge and what we understand ourselves when handling this much clients, there are around 3.5 million of cybersecurity jobs will be there by around 2021. And now in Corona time also, we know there are a lot of attacks happened because most of the people are working from home and they also hit with a lot of attacks. So I just want to tell to the students that the reason with that, you need a technical qualification or a technical background to start a career in cybersecurity. But no, this is my own experience. Even if I am from a technical background, I personally like to do some of the non-technical works in cybersecurity. So there are non-technical works also inside the cybersecurity field. Only thing is, you need to identify what exactly the caliber in the cybersecurity. Most of the people know CEH, and they once they completed the ethical hacking certification, they pretended themselves of the hackers. So I just want to say this one also, CEH is not the course for learning the hacking, and hacking is not the last word in the cybersecurity. So when we design each organization's framework, that is including the analysis part, some of the collection and operations of the asset part of the organization, and some of the maintenance part, even from the investigation part and protection defense, etc., there are some framework already in the cybersecurity. And in each area, there are position for students coming not only from a professional but also from other courses to fix. So some posts like security assessment, that is document assessment analyzer, some cybersecurity policy designer, cyber framework gap analyzer, cyber operational planner, and even some of the policy maker. So this all are the career which the student can actually choose, if even if they are coming from a non-professional or non-technical background. That is how I just want to tell the student. And there are a lot of courses available in the site also. I don't want to name all those certification, but there are, even students are also aware about us that. But I want to say this, the forensic analysis, the threat investigation, and the cyber policy generation is the three area which will be booming into next few years. So only thing is, if some of the students now pursuing their courses, you just want to focus on a next 10 year, because the cybersecurity, the trends is more changing by every day. So your vision will be in a long perspective of next 10 years, and you need to watch the sixth generation attack, which is happening every day right now. And most of the attack is focusing to the connecting devices and all. So you need to focus on the sixth generation attacks, what exactly the attacks are coming up, and you need to focus more into the next generation product and solutions also, so that you can actually design your strength and you can actually directly enter into the cybersecurity field. But I am sure that you will never be bored in this field of cybersecurity, because you are solving different problems and providing unique solutions in everyday basis.
That's a great advice. I think you will be receiving a lot of questions from the students after this. But if anybody of you wants to ask any questions from Jansi, we have kept 15 minutes at the end of the session. You can raise your hand and come on screen and talk to her one-on-one, or you can put your questions in the question section on the right, and we'll try to answer as many as we can. So, Jansi, like we talked about, what students should be doing in this field in cybersecurity, and how do you look at them to proceed in their career in this field. But from Strava Technologies perspective, I may be speaking from the student's point of view, but how do you support the students, and what offerings do you have for the students from Strava Technologies?
Yes, I understand. So as a cyber defense center, we are mostly focusing for the researchers, some of the, as I mentioned, the cyber threat intelligence, talk and manage the EDR and all. But there are few spaces for the students also, where we called CSAFE 360. We started in 2016, that is a cybersecurity awareness campaign, which we are developing some of the curriculum for the students to make themselves cyber aware, and also to promote others in perspective of the cyber awareness. So they can directly join us with through the CyberSafe, that is CSAFE 360, as a volunteer or an ambassador. And there are few steps for the evaluation criteria are there, and the team will support for those. Our team directly supporting those ambassadors and volunteers to improve their cybersecurity talents. And after that, we just giving some of the free advices also, and some of the placements also directly to the cyber workforce, where we already have some of the clients, and we directly refer them to those client circle itself. And this initiative is actually free of course. This is a part of our initiative. And as a part of the next level of CSAFE 360, we are soon launching a GCSE type of campaign, that is Global Cybersecurity Campaign. Actually, this is for this will act as a bridge between the Indian student and also the international student. And it is actually on its way, so that the students will get more chance to explore more into the international market also. So that is basically in our site itself, it will be there.
Got it. So great. If you guys want, we can share a direct link with you post the session, so you guys can visit the website and explore it much better way. So moving on, Jansi, let's move on to, somewhere when we talk about the startup ecosystem in the country. So how do you think what exactly is the market of cybersecurity startups product in the country right now, and how do you see it growing in the coming future?
When compared to the cybersecurity startup with other startup, there is not that much companies arise in the cybersecurity startup product and solutions. But when comparing to other startup area. But when I see few startups, they are actually established a lot of achievement in the cybersecurity area. So as I already discussed, now the organization is facing the challenges in managing their multiple point security, that is the product. The startups can actually focus in the sixth generation product and solution for that, since the attackers are actually more upgraded the sixth generation attacks and all, and there is a large volume of market in the next generation security product. So once you are actually planning to start a cybersecurity startup, your vision must be that sixth generation product and solution. And as I already mentioned to the students, startup also need to explore the market and understand what exactly market study, do a market study for a period of next 20 years or 10 years, because this is a time for, I say, nanotechnology. So when I suggest to the startup products or companies also, even now, bigger companies are actually started some of the cybersecurity startup as a part of their bigger organization and existing organization, and they are actually offering some of the cybersecurity services too. So like that, even somebody want to restart their career to the startup, they can directly check with such companies also what exactly they are offering as a cybersecurity services, or what, or they directly go to the product itself. That also market study they can definitely do. And I also personally know some of the startups like Karthikal and Lucidus and Sectona. So even they are Indian startup and they actually established their name in the cybersecurity field, and this change is accepting by the enterprise sectors also. Even to the government is also supporting some of the startups coming up with the cybersecurity solution. And this all happened, I think it is last 2 years, this much booming in the cybersecurity product and solution is I am watching nearly. And I think there must be more opportunity for the startups in India, not in India, but globally. And most of the global companies are actually looking into the Indian product and solution, because I personally know when we have also meeting, they are actually looking into, they have a bigger vision in Indian startups and their products.
Sure. You know, if you talk about some startups that are just creating a product in cybersecurity, then you very well said that you need to know the market where you're targeting your product in, right? So, you know, if you can tell a little bit more about how the Indian market is right now for cybersecurity, especially in the COVID times, if you know anything that you have read recently or any sources that you want to cite for people to read more.
So let's start with our area itself. So when before COVID and after COVID, or then the current period is actually for the cybersecurity startup companies, it is much beneficial, because when we are actually telling the cybersecurity in the organization, most of the organization is not spending that much money for the cybersecurity perspective. But right now, when we are hit with the COVID, most of the people are working from home, and they actually at that point they are thinking about the security of their data when they are transferring from their home network to the office network. So right now most of the companies are investing, that is from past 6 months itself, the investing of the cybersecurity product and solutions during this time is very high when compared to the time period before the COVID, and it will again increases, because we also already mentioned there are critical infrastructure, there are smart cities are coming, there are wearable devices, and there is another generation is coming with the industry perspective and all. So each and every industries will have a cybersecurity vulnerability or cybersecurity need will be there. So for a startup, if even if they are looking into a hospital sector, there are a lot of medical devices interconnecting, even from the MRI scanner to print that scanner to X-rays to everything. So they can actually look into those sectors, that is industry specific area also they can actually look into. And when we are speaking about the IT sector or even non-IT sector also, they are there are opportunities for this type of product companies to come up. And the main gap is what I identified personally is there is a gap in small and medium scale industries when compared to the large industries, because there are MNCs and there are larger players to provide their solution in the larger enterprise companies, but there are only few companies who are providing their product into the smaller medium level industry. So that there is a gap in that portion where the startup can directly look into, and even the our government is also supporting them. That is, national government is also supporting the startups to come up with the new idea and the new solution. Even in the cyber security, even DSA also supporting, NASSCOM is also supporting. There are a lot of agencies supporting in the cyber security firms and startups. So there's a bigger door is open for the cyber security startup to come up with the solutions and secure that products.
Great. There is one question for you, Jansi, from Unisys. So she says, what is your advice to organizations who have enabled work from home during COVID situation to protect themselves from cyber attacks?
Yes. I heard. So this is what I already mentioned. Even we also get a few inquiries in supporting the organization who are actually working from home. We just suggested the companies to make some of the endpoint security to these people who are working from the home, because they, most of the people, they don't have any security measurement in the home network, and they are dealing with the data which is critical and sensitive in a client perspective. So we already suggested most of the people who are working from home, even if you are using your personal devices or even if you are using your company's devices, please actually install an endpoint security rather than an antivirus, because most of the people right now also thinking antivirus is enough to protect their data. But make sure you are already having an endpoint security. And even in the market also, there are different products available for the endpoint security in different ranges. And some of them are actually protecting, they're preventing before downloading each and each mails or each PDF device, PDF like that, documents like that. So it is better to have an endpoint security at this point of time. This is a cost effective way. And there are a number of products also. And that can purchase by either the company or yourself, because it is your home network also. If hackers or attackers are actually targeting you, it will not only really affect you, but also affecting your family also, because most of the students are actually learning through online, using their devices and online devices, that is phone or laptop. So when somebody is actually looking into your data, automatically it will go to your family members' data also. So make sure you and your family members are protected in your home network.
Sure. There's one more follow-up question. He says, in the age of cloud transformation and distributed workloads, do you think architectures like zero trust, security access, service edge are helping organizations to protect data, identities, and applications?
Yes, that is my first point when I detailing about the sixth generation attacks. So the most of the attackers are actually targeting to the cloud area. Even most of them actually converted their storage to cloud. So that is how they are actually focusing. So that is the best way. But I already mentioned, if you are actually looking into a nano security or the framework for the nano security, that will be the best way to protect your organization. And make sure every time it is moved, it is actually changing your policies and the framework, and it will be reflect in the hierarchical wise itself. When we are saying about the development of the software, we will initially saying it's DevSecOps. So like the same way, you need to be design your critical, that is storage. Even if it is a cloud, there is some framework for designing the cloud security also.
Great. You know, Jansi, I'm getting some questions like, how can these students get associated with you? So I think for that, we will share one email ID by the end of this session, so that you guys can directly reach out to them and also follow their LinkedIn and Twitter pages to see what's recent is happening in the Cyber Defense Center. Right. There's somebody who has just asked, what does Strava uses AI in their security products?
Yes, I saw that. No, we are not using any AI because we don't have any direct product, and we are not in a way of developing a product for this one. What I already mentioned as first, we are actually consolidating the entire product of the security which is already having in their organization itself. So we are not using any AI for our product and solutions.
Great, I think that answers the question very well. One other student has asked, how should one build a career in cybersecurity right now? Do you suggest any courses which are available at the moment or any books that they should be referring to at the moment?
Well, I saw some of the nice syllabus in Coursera. Coursera, there are some of the contents already available for the cybersecurity stuffs. And I am suggesting a single book. What I suggest is go through the real-time news which you are getting through the online media. There are a lot of online news available, Hacker News. Every news are there. Even for the Checkpoint, they are actually publishing the research papers. So book is not enough to make you aware on the cybersecurity trends and all. So you must be following the real-time news and alerts. So you will get an idea of what exactly happening in the current situation. And as I already mentioned, the cybersecurity area is fluctuating. So once you are learning something in today, tomorrow morning it will again change. And if you are going to implement some security measures today, it will anyway breached by the attackers by tomorrow morning. So that is how I have already mentioned that this is very quite interesting area where you will not be get bored, and you need to think about the hackers. And that is how it will be. So there is no specific good book I really want to suggest, but I want to suggest you be aware of the real-time news, which I can also share you.
Great. I think we will share the link with all of you in the chat window, probably later on as well. So, students are really overwhelmed, I think, to connect and see what projects you guys are doing. So anything, any technology currently that you guys are building and working on that might help students to take help from?
Actually, we have a platform called Tubal. So Tubal is actually a testbed for the security, and right now it is only providing for the startups who are actually developing their product to make their test their security product and solutions. And it is right now not in a way to give to directly to students, but right now we are providing it to startups who are developing product for asset testbed. And we are providing the testbed to some of the electronic and hardware companies also to test their product if they have any cybersecurity vulnerability like that. But for the this one, we don't have any direct product to students. But in middle of that, I saw some question. Somebody is asking, like, the students are actually completing some courses in cybersecurity, but they are not getting any job directly. But right now, that question is not seen, but I saw somewhere. So I just want to tell that, yes, there are opportunities. So just go and check with not only, like, the bigger words, like, CISSP or CEH like that. But instead of that, there are courses for, like I already mentioned, some of the forensic investigator, cybersecurity analyst, security architect. Some of the particular courses are there. So most of the not only companies, even I think IBM is also providing some of the certification courses. And what exactly the organization is looking into is like, if you have any practical knowledge, they are not any going looking into the theoretical knowledge of your cybersecurity. For example, even if most of the companies, when we are also talking, they are actually recruiting some of the people having this type of certification. But after a few weeks or month, they analyze that that not that much experience in a practical way. We know that movie like Karate Kid, and he was actually telling, I know the entire theoretical and practical way, you just need to just advise me. That is what he was telling in that this movie. So like the same way, most of the students, not only students, I am telling most of the upcoming employees also from scaling stage also, they are telling like they know the cybersecurity, but when it comes to the practicality of a real scenario incident, it will not be that much established. So better you have already have a courses with you. Make sure once you appear for the interview, make them understand you already have a knowledge in the practical wise also.
Yeah, I think we have a very right question. I think where you just ended, somebody has said online practice resources are
CTF. Yes, actually I want to say this, this one we already have. We have an offensive defensive system, but right now we are launched in Hyderabad only for some of the employees of a certain organization, because it is a simulation lab and it is a little bit higher, and not directly we can right now push into the student perspective, but we have we are in a discussion how we can actually modelize this simulation lab for the student perspective also. The discussions are actually on the way. Once it is successfully completed by this month or next month, it will be going for the students also, so that they can actually get a visibility of the offensive and defensive training experience, like a blue team and red team, like that they can get the advantage. So that also we will soon announce when we are going to launch that one. But right now we are just only providing it for employees of the organizations.
Great. Any other session, Jhansi, that you plan for people outside Hyderabad, virtually probably you want to announce something like that?
Basically, we are conducting various sessions for our clients based on their demand. Some of their clients are also be there as a part of this type of talks, and most of the technical team is handling all those sessions because it is purely technical. So such kind of technical sessions also we are handling, but it is based on the request from some of the organization.
Got it. There's one other question, but it's in the chat window. It says, what can an organization do today to be better equipped with what quantum computer data hacking, if I'm pronouncing that right?
Which question?
It's at the bottom in the chat window. What can an organization do today to be better equipped to thwart quantum computer data hacking?
Seriously speaking, I am not that much aware about the thwart quantum computer data, but I know the quantum computer data. That is what I already mentioned. As we are already mentioned that this is nanotechnology. So nanotechnology is now grooming. As a part of that, the quantum computing also, there will be a chance, but I don't know, seriously, I don't know that much about the thought quantum computer data hacking. Better I can refer and give you the answer.
Sure. I think I would use this opportunity if somebody would like to talk to you on the stage. If somebody wants to raise their hand and come on stage, we are open to Q&As, so you guys can directly.
I saw one more question from Genga Raju, and we have learned like Security Onion, Burp Suit, Nexus and Splunk, etc. Question is,
yeah, that is not really clear, so that's why in case you want to come online and ask your question directly, that have more clarity to us.
But I think we can answer her like since she already having knowledge in the Security Onion and Burp Suit, they're actually looking into the career for cyber threat intelligence, because that is also an area where it is grooming, and most of the organization are actually now having this type of that threat intelligence as a main services for their businesses, and that way they can actually convert their career, because she's mentioned like cyber security, so they can actually look into cyber threat intelligence and yes, like that.
Okay, I think what she was trying to say is that these are some of the things that she has learned.
Okay.
In cyber security area. All right, I think that was great knowledge for the students in terms of, you know, what exactly they can do to enhance their career in cyber security, and what and where exactly Strava Cyber Labs can help them. And I think that has got these students really excited and how and what type of courses they can reach out to during current times. But you know, if you talk about the entrepreneurs in the cybersecurity field, Jansi, like you, maybe the motivation to a lot of women entrepreneurs out there. So what advice do you give to those cyberpreneurs, I should say, in this field, and how they should be taking up their career or maybe taking up their own cybersecurity product into the market?
As I mentioned, if they are focusing more into the product side, there must be some talent gap for getting it ready with the product side and all. But our government is also supporting to give some of the talent support and some of the funding support those who are looking into the product area. So once they are looking into the product area, there must be in their mind that they need to focus on the sixth generation cyber attack. That is, everything is connected. So make sure there is a product should meet the next generation security and not like that is a real-time prevention. And make sure they are exploring more into the next level security. It's like somebody is telling like that threat quantum computing and nanotechnology like that. So that is the way they can actually mold their product into next level. As a entrepreneur perspective, seriously saying, there are challenges and it will be there at the end of whenever you are in the entrepreneurship, it will be there as a challenge itself. So make sure when you hit with first challenge, not be shut down your startup or shut down your business. Let it come and face it. That is what I learned from my career background. So this is the only thing I also want to convey to those people who really want to get into the entrepreneurship, even if it is a male or a female, or even now children are also getting into this entrepreneurship. So like that, there will be challenges, but face it in a cool way.
That's quite true. I mean, I see students in the very early in their career, they start building a product and be very enthusiastic. I mean, if somebody is really interested in cybersecurity, there are a lot of other incubation centers who support these startups, and also the organization like yours provide a lot of opportunities and test beds to these startups. I would like to share that National Center of Excellence, which is a joint initiative of DSCI and Ministry of Electronics. We also have our own incubation center, which is in Noida Sector 126. And we offer opportunities in our incubation program to these startups in terms of giving them visibility and giving them a cover of NASSCOM 10,000 startups and helping them to connect with the industry, academia, and offering them piloting opportunities. And also for some mature startups, we connect them with investment opportunities as well. So if somebody would like to apply for this incubation program, you can visit National Center of Excellence page on Twitter or LinkedIn, or I can directly share the link also on the chat window and you can apply. This will be a really good opportunity for you guys. Any student in the final year who's trying to build a product and need help in developing their product further or need mentorship in the areas that they're trying to do, right? So we can offer them those help.
That's good initiative.
Yeah, so I think almost we started off in March, the incubation program. We have almost 12 cybersecurity startups at the moment. So we would like to encourage these budding entrepreneurs and students out there to take this this as a career opportunity, because I think a lot of students, they mentioned that they have studied a lot, they have read books and they have done courses, but now they lack direction in how to move forward and how to get up a job in this field of cybersecurity. So now this is one of the platform that these cyberpreneurs can utilize. I think somebody has asked a question, said that, so good to see a fellow women entrepreneur in cybersecurity, and they're introducing themselves, PQC Security Startup based out of Bangalore. Yeah.
So I just want to add with your point that there is an area for financial inclusion where the startups can actually look in. Not only the startup, even the students can also look into. So most of the banking sectors and the financial sectors are now more focusing with this financial inclusion. And the cybersecurity is also actually that is the major component for this particular thing. So even you completed your BCom with any computer application, or even you are purely from a financial courses, you can actually directly get into the cybersecurity by adding your that skill development in this area, and it will be an add-on for your syllabus also, which you are already completing any degree in the finance. And this is also the booming area where you can actually looking into. Even that is what I am telling, the initial stage, even if you don't have any technical background or non-technical background, students can also directly enter into this field. So I just want to note at that point also, the financial inclusion is a very good area for somebody who want to really develop a product in cybersecurity, and even students who really want to get into a career in the cybersecurity, that is a larger area.
Sure. I'm sure that helps, Shansi. I think somebody is asking to provide incubation support to product security startups. Yes, Hanan, we do. I have shared the link in the chat window, so you can access the complete information about National Center of Excellence from there and apply for the incubation. We do offer virtual incubation support in case you really don't want a physical space in the Noida campus. And I would like to share the contact details for to reach out to Jansi also, if somebody would want to reach out to her. Their website is stravacyberlabs.in, and here is the email ID which is popping up on your screen. You can look at, you can take a note of it, or we can just, you know, share it on the chat window for your convenience as well.
I saw some Purnima, okay. Assistant Professor KJ Somia College of Engineering. Okay, thank you, ma'am. Actually, I need to tell this one also. Even after COVID, once the education institute are actually open, they can actually start the cyber cell also, so that the students can actually get a hands-on experience from their own lab. They don't want to visit outside of their colleges. Even in the curriculum also, we need to add. But it will take few time, but the colleges can actually set up this type of lab in their colleges itself for giving the students a hands-on lab. And even the students can also set up their own lab in their college by communicating with the professors and all. So that will be a give and take like policy. The students also get an experience from the lab, and even the colleges also get a add-on with the cyber cell, that is the cyber lab and all like that. So if any professors who are actually hearing me, just keep this in your mind, or for the next year after the whole COVID and situation and all, make sure your college is actually supporting the students in their this cybersecurity career.
Great, Jansi. I think it really helped. I'm not from the cybersecurity field myself, but whatever we discussed today, it really enlightened me in the number of areas and the number of opportunities that has been opened up, especially in the COVID times. As we see, cybersecurity probably the only field where the companies are still thriving and they're still getting revenue and they're still improving in these times, if you compare it with the other industry.
Yes.
Great. I think I will give a last option to anyone who would want to ask any questions from you directly, and then we can wind up the session. We will also be sharing a feedback survey post the session, so that in case you guys have any questions left which went unanswered during the session, please feel free to reach out to us. I've also shared the credentials to reach out to Jansi directly in case somebody would like to reach out to them for any partnership or for any suggestions in terms of their programs that they offer.
Yeah.
All right. So I think that's all, Jansi. I think we are really happy that we could have some of your time spared for us and to have a peppy talk with all of us in cybersecurity.
Yes.
feel and motivating all the women who joined the session today in taking this field and not be scared about the cybersecurity courses and all that they don't get jobs and it's just a very technical jargon that they should be knowing in order to get into this. I think that's one personal learning that I take with me, that it's not just the technical learning that you can that can take you to heights in cybersecurity, but also the non-technical.
Yes. Thank you so much, Sonam. And actually, I want to thank the attendees also because there is a lot of questions is coming from them. So it is interactive session actually. So I also enjoyed a lot. Very very good attendees. That is what I just want to tell. And I also saw some of the questions in the middle. If any suggestions you want, you can just freely contact us. I can actually give you what exactly we need. I also having an agenda in my mind that we don't go for a pure technical session where the people also need to understand what exactly the opportunity and what exactly they are in the exactly happen in the cybersecurity field. So I hope it is useful in some mode. So thank you so much, Sona, and thank you so much for DSC also giving me the opportunity to interact with you and also the this much attendees. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for everybody else to join us today and have a great day ahead. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.